This video will help you find and cite quality sources using Google Scholar and to connect Google Scholar to the PCC library so you can access full-text articles available through PCC. Google Scholar is a search engine that's designed to specifically find academic and scholarly resources. I like to think of it as a mashup of a library database and Google. It finds quality scholarly content, but is as easy to search as Google. In Google Scholar, you'll find articles written by experts in a particular field that are also written for other experts in that field. Much of the content you'll find has gone through a peer review process, though not all of it. I'll show you later how to determine whether something is in fact from a scholarly peer-reviewed journal. If you're looking for newspaper or magazine articles and other articles written for a non-expert audience, you won't find them in Google Scholar, and you might want to try some of our other library databases. Most students who use Google Scholar don't know that you can actually connect it to PCC, so full-text links will be provided to any article available through the PCC library's many databases. To do this, click on the three-lined hamburger menu in the upper left-hand corner of the screen, select Settings, and then Library Links. You'll want to search for Portland Community College. Then just check the box that says Portland Community College, find it at PCC, click Save, and you're connected. Now, any link that is available through the PCC Library's databases will have a link to the right of it that says Find it at PCC. You can also use this shortened link or this QR code to take you directly to the Library Links page in Google Scholar settings. These settings last for quite a while, so you won't have to do that again for a long time unless you use multiple browsers or computers. I'm going to research a topic that there's a lot of conversations about in my profession: how to balance the library profession's values of free speech and expression with our values around social justice, diversity, equity, and inclusion. The first thing I do when I'm starting my research is to think of different keywords that describe my topic. If I don't know the topic that well, I might do some preliminary searches in Google or even Google Scholar and look at the titles of the results to get ideas. For example, intellectual freedom is the term commonly used in my profession to talk about free speech and free expression, but you may not know that if you're not a librarian. That's why doing some researching early on can help you brainstorm keywords. Now I'm going to try using some of these keywords for my initial search. I'm just going to start with social justice and intellectual freedom. This first search got me some good results. You'll find that a lot of the time, clicking on the hyperlinked title of the article will take you to the journal publisher's page for that article. Unless it's an open access journal, that page will probably not offer you full text and might even suggest that you pay some ridiculous fee for it. Don't ever do that. You'll also see links to the right of many articles in Google Scholar. Those will take you to free versions of the article, whether through PCC or not. If it's a Find It at PCC link, you'll first need to log in with your MyPCC username and password, and it will then take you into the database through which that article is available. If there isn't a link to a free version of the article, my advice is to use the library chat to ask a librarian. We can check and see if the article is available in full text elsewhere, or we can point you to Interlibrary Loan, where you can make a request and we'll get the article from another library. It usually takes up to 3 days to get an article through Interlibrary Loan, and it will come to you electronically. Even if your first search gets you good results, I'd strongly recommend trying other searches as well. I'm going to add in some additional terms, though I could also remove the original terms and just try these new terms. Each tweak of your search will bring new articles to the top of your search results. I'm adding in diversity, equity, inclusion, free speech, and expression. And while a few of these articles are familiar, there are a lot of new ones that rose to the top of the results for this search. As I go through the search results, I also try to make note of terms that seem significant that I can try in another search. Neutrality seems like a good one to add, as it's come up more than once. As I've mentioned before, while most things in Google Scholar are from scholarly journals, not all are. For example, if you see the word book next to the title, That means that the item is a book and will not be available in full text via Google Scholar. If it's relevant, you may still want to look it up through the library to see if we have the book or could get it for you from one of our partner libraries. But if you're only looking for articles, that one won't be a good fit. Also, this one at the bottom of the first page of results is actually a master's thesis that a philosophy student wrote to receive their master's degree. While it's academic, and it, or at least its references, could be really useful to you, if you have to use articles from scholarly peer-reviewed journals, this would not be okay to cite in your assignment. You may also find conference presentations, conference posters, unpublished manuscripts, and student work in Google Scholar. If you're not sure if something is from a peer-reviewed journal, just Google the name of the journal, which you can find right under the title. You may need to click on the publisher's page to see the full title if it's cut off in the Google Scholar results. By Googling the title, I can see to the right of the results that this is a peer-reviewed journal. I can also look at the Wikipedia page to get additional information about the journal's reputation and audience. This article looks like a useful one. I can access and download it through one of these two links, and I can also grab its citation in the format needed for my assignment by clicking on the Cite button. There are other really useful tools in Google Scholar. When I find an article that's really relevant to my topic, I can click on the Cited by link to see the articles that cited this article in their references. I can even search within that group of articles for ones that match specific keywords by clicking on the box Search Within Citing Articles. The Related Articles button similarly pulls up articles that Google Scholar's algorithm believes are similar to the original article. Another way to find additional articles is to look at the references of an article you've already found, because chances are, if the article is relevant, at least some of the sources they cite will be relevant to your topic too. Once you find something that looks good, search for that title in Google Scholar. Good luck with your research, and if you have questions or need any help, just ask a librarian.